Now, that gets us then to the big question is what are the factors that would cause reading to be a problem in children? Why is reading hard for some children and not for others? And there are several factors that we know that can impact the organization of the brain for reading. One I'm going to talk about very early in this talk, the second language learner, where we have a student who his first language might be an Asian language or it might be a Latin language like Spanish, and that student then is coming to school, and not only is that student expected to learn English, but they're also expected to read English books, and they're expected to listen to a teacher teach mathematics with English. So second language learning does affect the speed with which a child can learn to read and also learn other aspects in education. Some other factors are anything that interferes with the number, the pure quantity of language the child is exposed to. So if we have a parent who is in a single parent home and the mom has two jobs and she has three other children, and when she gets home at night, she's trying to make the ends meet financially, she's trying to prepare meals, she's trying to clean the house, she's trying to get the kids' homework done, she's trying to make sure that the clothes are ready for them to wear tomorrow, that parent doesn't have the luxury of sitting around with a two-year-old reading a lot of books to them. And so we know from research by Hart and Risley that parents who are under a lot of financial stress are often not having the luxury of talking as much to their children. And so those children have less exposure to language in general, and they just don't have as much quantity, so it takes longer for the brain to develop the network, pure and simple. Now, another thing that can affect a child's ability to learn language is if they've had anything that would interfere with the words getting into the brain. So a hearing loss, or even just having lots of colds or allergies in the first year of life or first 2 years of life, can really affect the way the brain, how much information the brain gets. So if you have a middle ear infection, let's say, you and I, our middle ear will be cleared out by the eustachian tube often within a few days. And so a cold may affect our hearing. We might notice our hearing is affected for a few days. A child, it can last 10 weeks or around that, just to clear out that middle ear, especially if they've had an infection in that middle ear. The fluid sticks around longer, and I'll explain that more later. But that causes a 30% hearing loss, and if you have a 30% hearing loss, that means 30% of the information coming in isn't getting to the brain. And if that's the case, then the brain doesn't have as much information to build these networks around. Now, we also have children who have specific language issues where language is just not their strong suit. I'll talk about that more. We have children who have attentional problems that may be hereditary or maybe related to other kinds of issues. We can talk about that in a few minutes, like they might have a language problem and so attending to language is hard. They might have trouble remembering things, so maintaining their attention is hard. I'll talk about that. And then we have children who have specific diagnoses like dyslexia, for example, that can impact their ability to read. So let's talk about